Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and we're doing microcannula high cheek and mid face, and this is just FDA approved by Galderma for microcannula use. We're very excited, so let's go, and we'll also talk about the parallel lines in this upcoming injection. Okay, so here we're gonna do cannula high cheek, and remember, when I'm eyeing it up, I'm looking at my parallel lines, the jawline and the cheek, and I wanna make those parallel. I wanted to make a nice, high, beautiful cheek for her. And I see a little vessel here. I'm gonna come in front, a little poke here. And then you don't have to go in beyond the dermis, that's it. Any more would be just creating a bruise. Now I'm making the opening bigger, but I'm not using the sharp. And so that will help avoid a bruise. So put a little pressure on our opening there. I'm going to use a 22 gauge cannula, and we just kind of find our opening. Usually it'll identify itself. I like to put something over the hair. It's nice to have a sterile gauze pad. And then now this is a bit of a larger cannula, so I'm hitting a little resistance. The sensation is on the skin on the outside. So oftentimes you can push harder than you think, and we move past that, likely an osteocutaneous ligament. To create some space, I'm gonna inject a little bit of product, and we're using Restylane Lyft, brand new indication for cheek mid-face cannula, which is amazing. One of seven new FDA indications that company has in the last 4 years. And I'm putting a little product in so I can dissect through the product, and that makes it comfortable for the patient. If I was just pushing, it's going to create more discomfort, but by putting a little bit of product down and then pushing, I'm creating a potential space. And now I want to watch where I'm going. The lateral canthus, to me, I know I wanted my high point here, my maximal light reflection. I'm using a 2-inch cannula so I can reach that. And if I can't, I push the skin over. So I don't have to make another opening, but if I needed to, I would come from the bottom and I would come up. But I don't need to because I can get where I want to be. This is a 22 gauge, so the flow is very quick and easy. And now I want to be a little more towards the apex and put a little bit of product there. And I want to stay higher because she's young, she looks great. We can stay higher and keep that high cheek and beauty. Restylane Lyft creates and holds its shape. It's a 900 micron size product. And I'll create a high cheek. If she didn't like it, after 3 to 4 days, and she wanted it more blunted and not so high, which is really rare for people to want that. But if she did, we could still mold that. So if it looks a little high when I'm done, I don't mind that. But I don't want it dull or nondescript, because A, that's not beauty, and B, we can create it afterwards. So there's a vial of Lyft, and I'm talking through it, but it's actually a very quick injection to do. And I always hold a little bit of pressure. We want the hollow here, and remember the parallel line here to here. So if we want to create that, that's what we're creating. And I keep that high cheek. There's no need to massage, if at all. A little bit of swelling can be due to a cannula, and that will come down. But I want that high apex. So thanks for joining me today for microcannula injections of the recently FDA approved method from Galderma. Join us on this channel, subscribe below. Also pop over to Instagram for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.